Ooh, I got a new pair of shoes. It's the new pair of SuperLitesXP. Thank you, FootJoy. I love this pair a lot because it's super light and easy to clean. Hi, my name is Darren and welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to play at a golf course that has lots of history. I'll give you some clues. It's narrow, it's tight, it's undulating, and you can or you may or I have lost lots of golf balls. I'll give you another clue. It used to have monorail. Do you know where this is? If you have guessed that this is Keppel Country Club, then you are correct. I would like to thank Keppel Country Club for giving me the opportunity to play the golf course and as well do the course vlog. But before we head down to the golf course, let's do an unboxing of the new pair of... So here we are at hole number one. It's about 300 meters and there's a bunker on the right side. It's about 245 to carry and I think I can carry it. So I'm just going to aim slightly left of the fairway and fade it back. It's going straight for the bunker. Carry! Did it carry? I guess my ball did not carry the bunker. I thought I could. But I think most golfers are the same, right? They think they can carry something, but in the end, we don't hit that far. Anyway, I just lucked out. I'm just before the bunker. And I've got about 55 meters to the pin, slightly uphill. And the pin is just below a slope. So I'm okay with this ball just going pin and then let the slope take the ball back towards the hole. That went slightly to the right, but I think it's going to be good. Kicks left. My ball landed here and it rolled right to left. As you can see, there's a back slope at the back and then it came back towards the hole. So not bad for the first hole. And always fix your ball. Wow. Hole two, a 400 meter par four. It's dog leg left. And you got to keep the ball onto the fairway. What am I talking about? Every hole you have to put it on the fairway, especially on this course. And I think I only brought like 3 balls today.
You what?
Hopefully I get to keep all of them. Maybe if you're lucky, we get to find some balls along the way as well. So the plan is to aim for... You see there's 3 buildings, the one in the middle. Aim for that and draw it in. Anything right of that? There goes my ball. Okay, focus. High draw. Start line, high draw. I think that's pretty good. Oh, it's a bit wet today. So I've got some lateral water hazard. As I press down on my feet, there's some water coming out. So I need to have a drop. Somewhere is, but everywhere is wet.
Bro, go up to your right.
Knee drop. Okay.
and we have 124 to the pin downhill. Sit. All right. Not bad, I like these shoes actually. They're pretty stable even if it's wet. Now where did my ball land? Okay. Good. Guys, remember when you play golf, please always fix your ball mark. When you come onto the green, fix one ball mark and fix two more. Every two more you fix, you get one birdie. Let's just see if it's true or not. I just fixed one, right? Let me find one more first. Okay, one more. And there we go. Straight, firm, and birdie la Liao. See what I meant? Fix two ball marks or more, you get a birdie. So as we reach hole three, we have to go through this road in between. And as you pass by, you see this beautiful fountain. This hole is a par 4 dogleg left and it's about 370 meters. Let's go with the driver and aim right down the middle of the fairway. So much for middle of the fairway. I pulled it left and I hope it's safe. So now my ball's in a bad lie, it's not good. And I've about 130 meters to the pin. I'm thinking of hitting 135 meter with one more club up. So if I were to make a mistake, I will still sort of luck out. Excellent. Hit that slightly behind, but because of the extra club, turned out well. Fix. Fixed divert. Start line. 1.5 cups right. And hit it firm. What? That's golf. So now I've got 144 to the pin. And we have hit wind. So effectively, if I were to hit this shot, I would say it's gonna be about at least 150 to the pin. Now my full seven is about 154. And I don't wanna hit a hard seven or a full seven because if the wind catches my ball, I'm gonna hit this shot. So I don't mind being in the center of the green. Let's go with a 6-iron. Let's hit it like a 160 meter shot. So it's going to be a 3/4, 80% smooth, 6-iron. And let's play for 160. Is it going to draw back? I pushed this slightly to the right, but I got the right distance. Okay, so now I'm pin high. I would say some greens to work with. I need about 50% carry. So I've got a lob wedge in my hand. Open slightly. Shaft raise to expose the bounce. Just aim it slightly right. And the ball should trickle towards the hole. Okay. Not bad. For par. We got our first par 5 on this 9. I'm going to aim the left edge of the bunker and fade it back to the center of the fairway. Otherwise, my ball would enter the bunker. So let's hit a fade. Cut some more! Some more! Fairway, I saw the ball. Okay, so I've got 202 meters to the pin with the ball. I'm gonna hit a 3-iron. My 3-iron goes about 200 meters carry. So I don't expect for this ball to get onto the back of the green. But maybe front or middle is good. Sit. Okay, on the green. Just shot the green on the right side. To land on the ball onto the green, I've got about 60% carry. And yet I still want the ball to run up. So I'm going to go with a 50 degrees instead of a wedge and a wedge. So it feels like I'm going to hit a slight waist to waist with just a bit of shaft lean. And if the ball lands, it's going to roll towards the hole. And release some more. Oh, still not enough. I would say that this is my favorite hole or par 3 on this course. Just look at the view. Nice, huh? So we've got 131 meters to the pin. I've got an 8-iron. And this will be a 3-quarter swing. Stay left. Oh, just got onto the green. Okay, we have a long birdie putt. I would say a medium to long putt. It's going to be slow uphill, slightly right to left. And I've been using a new saw grip. Hopefully, in the next 2 to 3 weeks, I'll get really used to hitting with this new putting style.
Whoa!
Not bad, right? Okay, hole 7 is a short and very narrow par 4. I have some beef with this hole because the highest score I shot on this hole was, I think, close to triple par. Maybe it was a 10 or 11 when I was a junior. And I remember I used a driver and it got me into trouble. Many years fast forward now, I'm still going to use the driver and this time I'm taking my revenge. So the plan is to hit a high cut just left of the PSA building. You will see the building just up ahead and fade it back. Let's go. Safe. Now we're left with 68 meters to the pin. I've got a lob wedge in my hand and 70 is a comfortable number. So let's go straight for it. Hopefully we get it close enough for another birdie chance. Ooh, I think that's really close. Okay, let's see. Okay, good. So we've got another chance. Ball landed here and did a big hop. Ha! Huh? Not right leap, ah? Par 4. It's uphill. We're going uphill and then it swerves to the left. You definitely do not want to be on the right side. And you know, normally we don't take out drivers on this hole, but I think this is going to be the last time I'm going to play on this course. So yeah, what the heck? Let's just go for it. So driver over the left edge. Start line. And then draw it all the way back in. I like it. Now let's see where it ends up. So now my ball landed up on top of the hill. And it's quite a long walk from the buggy to up the hill. I'm kind of tired, so I'm going to catch my breath just a little bit. So let's talk about this shot. I've got 70 meters to the pin, and there's a bit of a headwind. I've got a lob wedge, and I think I took the wrong club because I should have taken two clubs instead when I got up here. So I just need to hit about 70. And I should be fine. Okay, just left of the green. Not the best, but I'll take it. Okay, so the usual protocol is when your ball is off the green or even on the green, we always want to check the lie. So over here, the ball is actually sitting pretty okay, but there seems to be like a small hole in front of my ball, so I expect the ball is going to jump a little bit. So I don't think this ball is going to be running smoothly, so I can take that into account. And then I'm going to feel and check the slopes. So I feel it's right to left here. Same right to left, and then slight right to left here. So I've got a right to left putt. We are downhill, but because the greens are slow, so I'm still going to hit it firm with a bit of right to left. So I'm looking at about maybe a putter grip, half a putter grip right. And I just want to have good pace. Too much good pace. Okay, ninth hole, par 5, it's pretty straightforward, it's just straight. Hit it straight, put it on the fairway, stay out of trouble, save your golf balls. I can't put this two on, so I'm not going to whack it. 80%. And this is what we call a fairway finder. So much for finding the fairway. Oh, I lucked out. I actually put it to the left. Hit the slope and then went back to the center of the fairway. See? Fairway finder. Now I've got a 6-iron for my second shot. The only reason why I'm taking out 6-iron because I'm left with about 250 and the edge of the water is about 100 meters out to the center of the green. So you just take a club and lay up to about 100 meters and you'll be fine. I love the grip on these shoes. I think these shoes are really great because first, it's really comfortable and there's good traction on it. Do consider, they're out in the stores now. Okay, so we've got 102 to the pin. And the pin is in front, it's a red pin, it's just behind the bunker. So we're not gonna get too cute on this, and I'm just gonna hit it straight to the middle of the green. I've got an approach wedge, so it's gonna be a full wedge. I'm gonna put it at the back of my stance so I can slightly lower through the shot. So ball slightly at the back. I hit it slightly fat again, but it carried the front and we're just at the front edge of the green. My ball just landed here, it hopped up. And I'm glad that I put my ball at the back of my feet so that it still could come out a bit lower and actually get the ball towards the green. Lie is okay. It's really thick here, so I need some speed to get through the first 10% of this putt. And then it goes downhill, left to right. It's a bit more severe here. So I think I've got about 1 grip left. Okay. One grip left and still firm. Oof. Wow. More than that.